Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest rose to being a multi-millionaire after being homeless.
Yes.
All by just talking about taxes and how to save money and investing in your future. We have today James Hunt, who's right back today as it is tax season.
Yes.
Teaching us what and truly we should be doing this month.
Yes, it is absolutely important. It is absolutely important that you get a grip on your credit, you get a grip on knowing what your score is and knowing what you qualify for, and making sure that not just when you're ready to actually make a purchase and your back is up against the wall, but that you know all of the things that you need to know and doing all of the things that you need to do.
Why is it so important that we make sure we maintain great credit for our financial life?
Yeah, because the majority of people who come to me when their back is up against the wall and they haven't done what they needed to do to maintain it, and all of a sudden they're turned down and they're in the process of closing and they can't get the house. And so they come to me desperately to make things happen for them.
And listen, that's as they stated earlier, I'm an advocate of, financial investing, making sure my credit is where it needs to be. I check it all, like, almost every other month, to be honest with you. Yes. And I think that that kind of keeps me ahead of the ball. Why do you think, and I noticed this, when I go to different zip codes, right? I noticed that in our African American communities, the zip codes there, the scores are substantially lower. Why is that?
So they do demographics based upon certain zip codes and where you live at, and whether and creditors do it and decide on whether to actually give you credit, because if you're in the area that you live in, the majority of people are not paying or pay late, then there's likely, even if your score is high enough, that they may not give you the credit.
So just based off where you live, could have a bearing on if you're being issued credit or a certain type of, interest rate or APR.
Yes, it is a factor.
Oh my God, that's unfair.
Mm, it is unfair. But creditors need this model to actually decide on what's going on in that community and whether people in that community will actually pay. It's not fair. It's not.
It's really not. I was gonna go there, but let me stick to the script. So, what are some misconceptions that we have in terms of what can be removed from our credit report and what cannot? And then I want to talk about the length of stay of things being on your credit report.
Okay. So the misconception is that just because you have something negative in your credit report that it can't come off. Mm-hmm. And my advice is that you cannot live with the negative issues. You should be proactive with going after anything that you have in your credit report that's negative. The law says that creditors have to be able, the Fair Credit Reporting Act, which is the law that governs creditors and credit reporting agencies, that the creditors have to be able to prove that the information that is being reported in your credit report is actually true. Mm-hmm. And if they can't, disputing it is holding their feet to the fire, to making sure that they have all of the documentation to prove that that account actually belongs to you and the issues on that account is actually accurate.
Sometimes people think, well, you know, I know I have this on my credit, shouldn't be here, but it's going to cost so much more money to dispute it. Should they go out and hire legal aid for that, or should they even, is it a simple process of just going on to the credit bureau of their website and hitting dispute and doing it yourself for free?
Yeah, so the average person can actually dispute most things by themselves. So they don't have to necessarily come and see a person like me. But if you can't handle it and you got something that's up against the wall and it's major and it's stopping you from getting something major, you should probably call a professional.
Absolutely. Why do we have three credit bureaus? We have TransUnion, Equifax, and Experian. Why do we need three?
Well, I don't know that we need three, but we have three, and they all, most people think that they're different ones and different ones are more important than the other. They're all equal, but different creditors pull from different credit reporting agencies. So you need to know what your score is on each one of the credit reporting
agencies. However, we all like to get a 3-3 credit score and one and whatnot, but sometimes you can go on and have those three credit scores, right? Mm-hmm. Where there is a system that's facilitating that. But when you go and you directly go to that particular bureau, say for instance, if I have an Equifax, TransUnion, Experian, I'm getting it through Equifax. If I pull my TransUnion, it might be different from the actual TransUnion Bureau. What are they doing to actually calculate those scores? Because I've seen that happen.
Yes. So each one of the credit reporting agencies have different scoring models. Mm-hmm. And so your score may be off with your Experian credit score may be different if you pulled it from TransUnion from what it actually shows on Experian or the way it shows on Equifax. And so my advice is to go directly to myfico.com, and FICO gives you the official credit score, and they will show you all three.
Really quickly, before we wrap, I really want the viewers to know they're changing some of the rules in the FICO score. Can you give us a few?
So the new FICO 09 system is the new system that calculates it now accounts for your rent payments can be calculated so that you can it can help you get towards going from being a renter to a home. Medical bills have less factor in the new 009 scoring system. So there's all kinds of new factors that are in the credit reporting scoring system for 09 that helps the client to get better credit and to get a higher credit score.
All right, and where can they go, really quickly, this is so important to me, guys, where can they go to find out about the changes in the FICO 09?
So, directly to FICO. So FICO, myfico.com will give you all of the details. These days, you do not have the luxury of saying, I don't know. Everything is available at your fingertips.
Mm. No excuses, good people. Yes. No excuses. Listen, thank you so much, James, for joining us. We truly do appreciate it. If you want more information, please follow him on Instagram at James Hunt.